Dear students, the topic of my next lecture is modifications in ring frame, which I will cover in two parts. In first part, I will start with roving guides. This one is a diagram of roving guides. Diagram A shows conventional, and this one is new type of roving guide which is used in tensor ring spinning machine. In conventional roving guide, the wear on the roller at the extreme ends of the strokes is quite high due to sine curve like movement of the guide. Ginzer has developed a roving guide where the movement of the guide is combined of small straight lines that evens out wear on the top roller over the whole traversing width, as shown in this diagram. With an improved roving guide drive, wear on the top drafting cylinder is reduced, increasing the service life of the top rollers. Next modification is delayed startup of the drafting rollers. The drive for the drafting rollers is a rigid one by gears, and the spindle is driven by a flexible drive, that is belt. The initial belt tensions on both sides of the spindle are same while the machine is at rest. When the ring spinning machine is started, the belt tension in the forward direction increases, and at the back it decreases enough to build up the required torque on the spindle. Additional slackness present on the spindle belt compounds the problem. The acceleration of the spindle lags behind that the drafting rollers, and the yarn slackens. If it slackens too much, this might lead to balloon instability and an end break. Delaying the startup of the drafting rollers by a few seconds would solve this problem. In Marzoli ring frame machine, at the beginning of the cop build up, the starting of the drafting rollers is delayed so that the spindle starts to rotate first, which tightens the initial yarn ends, and this problem is solved. Now, next modification is modification in drafting arrangement. As shown in this diagram, conventional bridge shaped cradle are flat with a step guide. New bridge cradle are designed with a convex shape or arc, or you can say deflection of the bottom apron. With the new design, the top and bottom aprons assume concave and convex shapes respectively in the working region and are kept at a higher tension compared to that when running on flat cradles. This type of arrangement extends the pressure field on the fibers held by the middle rollers close to the front rollers, improving the guidance of short fibers. When spinning finer yarns, fewer fibers are drafted and arc-shaped cradle might be useful. Arco-bridge cradle are recommended for compact and fine yarns. It has been shown that this type of cradle reduces yarn CV percent and imperfections by 40% and improves yarn strength by 18%. This one is another modification. In this, the top apron extended into the back zone at its extreme back end. It pushes and deflects the fiber strand down from the back roller. This arrangement gives improved fiber guidance for short fibers, and hence an improvement in evenness of the yarn is obtained. This was all about modifications in drafting arrangement. In next part, I will cover modifications in different types of rings and travelers. Thank you.